We're here today to talk with Carlos about some of his recent work regarding nanotechnology and biomaterials in the treatment of human disease. So Carlos, you recently had a publication in the Journal of American College of Surgeons. Could you tell us a little bit about that publication and what that the results of that work?
This publication was, the study was about diabetic foot ulcers, and we were trying to develop a new treatment for these foot ulcers. This treatment is based on a combination of two different therapies, the nanotechnology and gene therapy. The nanotechnology part is a nanoparticle that we've been working on with our collaborators at UCF, University of Central Florida. This nanoparticle can be used to deliver treatment, but also it can target oxidative stress. And the other part is the microRNA 146A. MicroRNAs are small molecules that can regulate gene expression and protein production in every tissue in the body. So this particular microRNA can target and inhibit inflammation. So it basically works as an anti-inflammatory. And what we did, we combined these two together. We conjugated the microRNA on the nanoparticle, and we used that to deliver the treatment. We used that treatment to treat the diabetic wounds with it. And we found that this treatment improves the healing of these ulcers compared to ulcers that were not treated.
So how effective is your therapy? Is this therapy relative to known therapies that are out there?
So what's unique about this treatment is that it targets inflammation and oxidative stress synergistically. The treatments that are available right now, they can target one process. For example, it can target inflammation in the wounds, or it can target oxidative stress in the wounds. Our treatment can target both at the same time. And what we see is that these diabetic wounds can heal almost at the same rate as non-diabetic wounds, as normal wounds.
So you mentioned earlier that this was done in collaboration. You want to tell us a little bit about collaboration and why that's important in developing these therapies?
Collaborations are very important when you're doing research. You can bring different teams together with different ideas, different products, different point of view, and you can develop a new treatment that's going to be competitive. For example, the group at University of Central Florida, they're experts in nanotechnology and biomaterials, and they're nationwide known, and they've been working on in that field for a long time. Our group is more an expert in the biology of diabetic foot ulcers and all the deficiencies of diabetic foot ulcers. We understand the biology, they understand the bioengineering side of things. By bringing the teams together, we were able to develop this effective therapy for diabetic foot ulcers.
So on this campus, there's some unique aspects in that there's the Mine University or Colorado School of Mines, mm-hmm. Which you have a collaboration with. There's the bioengineering group. There's the critical care medicine group. You want to talk a little bit about how these are all integrated around this technology?
Actually, we recently we started collaborating with Dr. Melissa Krebs from the School of Mines. Dr. Melissa Krebs is also a bioengineer, and we started that collaboration with her because we were interested in developing a topical formulation of our treatment. So, and Dr. Melissa Krebs has this unique gel called Zwitteronic gels, and we're working with her to incorporate our treatment into this gel, which will allow us to deliver the treatment at a certain speed into the wound, so it progressively releases the treatment into the wound. And what's important is that this can be applied topically by the patient directly, and the patient doesn't need to go into a specified clinic to receive this treatment.
Great. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Dr. Lichtenberg.